tonight.
We've probably had sex less than 20 times in the 5 years that we've been married. It's humiliating.
Nearly no communication, intimacy, or sex.
So this is where it all happens or it doesn't happen.
Are you willing to tell me the absolute truth?
On the eve of their anniversary.
What is this?
Iyanla dives in.
You don't have to be broken and wounded to get love. If he cannot find the comfort in you, he will seek it elsewhere. But he's already done that, right?
What did she offer you that your wife doesn't?
What's broken here, man?
The secret he's been holding on to.
What is it that you're not talking about?
The truth is that...
Next.
Life happens to everybody, even me. Life didn't care that I had written a bunch of books, traveled the world speaking, married the love of my life, lived in my dream home, and made a bunch of money. And then life left me broke and feeling broken. The only way to get back was to do the work. I did my work and put my life back together piece by piece. I am Iyanla Vanzant, and I am here to help you do your work.
I'm on my way to Tiffany and Nick on the eve of this fifth anniversary. And they are having a little problem in the bedroom.
Nick and Tiffany are a Knoxville couple whose sex life died the night they got married.
We've probably had sex less than 20 times in the 5 years that we've been married.
Tiffany first met Nick 8 years ago.
From the minute I met him, I knew that that was the person I was gonna marry.
We used to be very intimate. Just always holding hands, always kissing.
It took 3 weeks to consummate our marriage.
I think not doing it that first night kind of got the engine rolling for Tiffany.
It's humiliating. Makes me feel like that I'm not good enough, that I've just been kind of tossed to the side and used for when he needs me.
Tiffany desperately wanted to be a mother. Because they so rarely have sex, she decided to adopt. Tiffany and Nick believe if their sex life doesn't improve, their marriage could be over.
I'm unhappy because I don't feel loved. I don't feel like I have a friend in my husband. I feel ignored, and I feel really, really lonely.
The nagging, the controlling, just the way you're spoken to through the day, it makes me feel small.
Have I considered divorce? Absolutely. I don't believe I can live this way for the rest of my life.
Sex is 10% of the deal. It's an important 10%, but it's 10%. There is something else, many things else, that are missing. This could make it or break it. This could make it or break it. It's a crisp Tennessee morning. Mm-hmm. I've never seen a black picket fence. I've seen a white picket fence. Never seen a black one. Good morning. Hi. Well, you didn't know I was coming? Hello. Hello. Oh, aren't you beautiful? Look at your little teeth. Okay, let's close the door. Hi, how are you? You're Nick?
My name's Nick, yes. How are you? Nice to meet you.
Good, thank you. This is your room?
This is our room, yes.
Okay. How wonderful. Ooh, it's a little tight, isn't it?
It is tight. It's a small house. The ceilings are small to start with, and to go along the roof line just have to be small.
Okay.
Yes.
Have a seat for me.
Oh, gosh. Okay.
Wow. So this is where it all happens or it doesn't happen.
Huh? Yeah.
Ooh, it's tied up in here. I'm looking at this and I'm just blown away. That looks very intimate to me.
Mm-hmm.
Were you intimate then?
Yes.
Okay. You know, so when I look at that, when I look at this, I'm like, what the hey? See, those two people could have sex. These two could not. What is this? What is this? Put that together. Put that back together.
It's still the same picture.
Right. Did you hear what he said? Mm-hmm. Still the same picture. Because if there's a problem in the marriage, it's you. You the problem. Yeah. And you the problem. There'll be times today where you are not gonna like me. I'm okay with it, really. Because I know it'll shift. And the awareness will come. I know that. Are you willing to tell me the absolute truth?
Yes.
Are you in?
Yes, ma'am.
So why am I here?
I just want to be able to express myself.
Yeah.
And without someone telling me I'm saying the wrong thing or, you know, I don't know.
I'm getting ready to make love to your husband.
Sorry.
I'm going to show you how it's done.
Okay.
That's how you do it. That's how you do it.
I'm not very good at that.
He just needs to know that when you look at him, you accept him for who he is. And it comes from the heart, not from the head, and not below the waist. Gotta be present. Yeah. I didn't even have to touch him.
I don't know how to be present.
Until today. Yeah?
Thanks.
Mm-hmm. Why am I here, Tiffany?
Because I don't want to feel this way anymore. I want my daughter to have a good role model to grow up to. Mm-hmm. We adopted baby very quickly.
Yeah, we're going to talk about that. I really want to know what that's about.
I wanted to be a mother no matter what.
No matter what?
No matter what.
Yeah, but how selfish is that? No matter what. So no matter what, no matter that my husband and I have a broken bond, my husband and I aren't communicating, I'm in control, I'm not settled and clear about what it means to be a woman, he's having some challenges when it comes to expressing his masculinity, but I want a baby, so I'm gonna have it. Are you open to the possibility that it was a selfish thing to do?
Yes.
Okay. Go ahead, you can cry if you want to. Now what would happen, my beloved, if you just went and sat over there and let your wife cry into your chest? Go sit back there. What is wrong with you people?
I don't know how to do that.
Put your head on that man's chest and let him hug you. Let him hold you. Can you hold her a little better than that, please?
Arms crossed. I'm sorry.
Miss Tiffany, you get your coat, you come with me. It's time to talk to Tiffany about what's really going on here. I asked Tiffany to meet me at a local park.
How did we get here, Miss Tiffany?
How did we get here?
Oh, it's such a long story.
No, it doesn't have to be. I don't need the details. If you had to tell me your story, you know, like when you're in school, you have to do them 500-word essays?
Yeah.
500 words.
Right.
If you had to tell me your story in 500 words, what would it be?
I'm a broken girl that wants to be fixed.
A broken girl that wants to be fixed. And how'd you get broken?
I think it kind of came that way.
Absolutely not. Absolutely not. Where did you get that from, that you came here broken?
My parents.
Tiffany says she was removed from the home of her birth parents when she was 3 weeks old. A year later, she was legally adopted. Tiffany claims she was abused by her adoptive father for the next 18 years.
I just want to feel good and not be that 12-year-old kid anymore.
12? Why 12?
That's when I finally told on my dad.
Told on your dad at 12? Mm-hmm. Told what?
That he sexually abused me.
Okay. Wow, that's a lot. And he sexually abused you, and who did you tell?
My mama.
Yeah.
And what did she say?
She said, I'll never choose you over him, and I'll take you back to the foster home.
Okay, now you're telling me that? Whew. And that is all locked in your body. That's locked in your body. You use other people to make you feel good about you. Because men use you to feel good about themselves. They taught you how to do it, and you do it every day. I'm in Knoxville, Tennessee, helping a husband and wife who say they've had sex less than 20 times during their 5-year marriage.
The topic of sex turns into an argument probably 90% of the time.
The reason Nick and I don't have sex is he gives me a million excuses.
It's just so frustrating sometimes. So frustrating, and you just want to just give up.
I met with them this morning to help them understand that their lack of intimacy has little to do with sex. Now I'm meeting with Tiffany at a local park. She's already revealed she was abused as a child.
Told on your dad at 12. Mm. Told what?
That he sexually abused me.
Come here. Mm. I love this. You know what this is? This is a magnolia tree.
Before we sit down, I find something I can use to help Tiffany visualize her trauma.
Let's get in out the Tennessee cold.
In addition to the years of abuse from her adoptive father, Tiffany opens up to me about another painful secret. She says she was also sexually abused by a family friend.
The one that stands out the most is the neighbor other than my father. The neighbor who did, he did almost in one night what my father did to me in 12 years.
Tell me what you mean by that.
He violated me in one night, mm-hmm. in the same amount of violation that my father did in 12 years. And there was nothing that anyone did, and they all knew. And I was 4. Mm. And I can see his sheets right now.
Whose sheets?
The neighbors. I can see his covers. I can smell the smell in his bathroom.
Okay, stop. Take a breath. Stop and take a breath. And make another choice. Why would you hold that image and go into that and re-imprint your body with that? You don't have to be broken and wounded and sorrowful to get love. You don't. But where can love get in with all of them stories? Those are horror stories. You got a beautiful big piece of hunk of man crawling into the bed with you every night, and you lay there and allow yourself to be ignored and rejected. That's a very angry, ugly thing to do.
Right.
If he cannot find the comfort in you, he will seek it elsewhere. But he's already done that, right?
A year after Tiffany and Nick were married, he revealed that he had been married once before. He also admitted he has cheated on her.
Well, I found out that he had been married before me and didn't tell me, and then we were having some issues because I was really upset about that, and then I felt like he just paid me back by cheating on me.
He withheld. Mm-hmm. But you withhold yourself from him every day that you don't give him your heart. As a woman, you give him your intellect, your thinking, not your heart, because it's closed.
Tiffany is a photographer, so I had her take a picture that symbolizes the current state of her marriage.
What does this represent?
I feel like if I did the right things, that this would fill out and be the pretty tree that it's supposed to be.
And still, I bet you this tree has roots down there. And here's the trunk that gives birth to the experiences that bear fruit. I want us to take a look at the trauma in your tree and clear it out.
I want you to tell me, share with me, if you can, my beloved, about the events and circumstances of your life that have brought us to the place we are today.
I just felt, you know, violated my whole life.
What else?
I mean, always lonely.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. What else?
Stupid.
Stupid. Mm-hmm. What else?
Ugly.
Events and circumstances. Lonely, ugly. So, I have something for you.
Okay.
Because it just comes a time when you just gotta be cozy.
Thank you.
I want you to find in your body, tell me where in your body, the most intense place, where is it in your body? Right here in your heart. I thought you might say that, so I brought this. This is your yoke.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. This is my bag of tricks.
Okay.
Yeah, so, you know, the being violated. Being unwanted. Tiffany has no idea that her negative thoughts about herself are poisoning her marriage. Or, you know, like when we have unresolved issues and then we go out and adopt a child to try to make ourselves feel whole when we haven't resolved our issues.
Yes, that one's a hard one, though.
Yeah. If you don't tell that truth, then you're gonna keep deluding yourself. Tell me what you just heard me say.
I don't want her to feel like
I didn't ask you that. I asked you to tell me what you just heard me say.
That I used my baby?
To do what?
To make myself feel whole.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Can you own that?
Want to.
I didn't ask you if you wanted to. You didn't want to be raped and violated. You didn't want any of that. But beloved, look what you've created. You created it. Can you own that there's a part of you that uses your daughter to make you feel better about who you are? Now, you don't wake up in the morning and say, oh, let me just go use somebody. But this is the pattern. This is the pathology. Because men used you to feel good about themselves. They taught you how to do it, and you do it every day. It's just a reality. I mean, I know this might look ridiculous, Tiffany. Look at your heart. Where can he get in there? Look at that.
Nowhere.
Okay. So there's right along the side of your hands right here are all the nerve endings in your body. And from the years and years and years of telling those stories, every single one of your nerve endings is now filled with that poison. Do you understand that?
Mm-hmm.
Come right here with me. Come right here with me. I want you to do this.
Oh.
I want you to do this. Just do that. Yeah, just
do
that. That's all right. That's all right. We want them crushed and crumbled. You understand? We want them off your heart. Even though. There's a part of me.
There's a part of me.
That just doesn't want to let it go.
That just doesn't want to let it go.
Yeah, come on. Come on. Because it's familiar.
Because it's familiar.
I can manage this.
I don't know how to manage it.
I've become more comfortable.
I've become more comfortable.
Being in pain.
Being in pain.
Than running the risk.
Than running the risk.
Of being powerful.
Being powerful.
And there's a part of
there's
me.
There's a part of me.
That just doesn't want to let the pain go.
Just doesn't want to let the pain go.
And I'm still willing. I'm
still willing.
To love and accept myself.
To love and accept myself.
Take your hands out. By tapping out the trauma, we gradually clear away the dead leaves that represent what has been buried in Tiffany's heart. So on a scale of zero, where zero is, oh, the tree is gone, all of the roots are gone, and 10 where, oh my God, I'm stuck in this place forever. Where are we? Check your body.
I mean, I feel like I'm at a one,
okay.
Or zero, you know?
Did you notice that you said that without shedding a tear?
No. I've cried quite a bit today. Well, now that you said it, yeah.
Yeah. that you're willing to tell your truth and face the consequences, knowing that you will be okay.
I think this is done.
Were you strutting your stuff when you had that affair? What did she offer you that your wife doesn't?
This morning, I began the work with Tiffany and Nick, a Knoxville couple who stopped having sex the night they got married.
I just want to be able to express myself without someone telling me I'm saying the wrong thing.
I suspect the roots of this dysfunction go deeper than the marriage.
You use other people to make you feel good about you.
Now it's time to talk to Nick.
I'm afraid that we're not gonna be able to work it out.
I've asked him to meet me at a local scrapyard. I want to put him in touch with the emotional debris cluttering his marriage.
We sometimes have to go through and sort out the junk and the treasure.
Is Tiffany your junk or is Tiffany your treasure?
I mean, she's definitely not my junk, but she was once my treasure.
And what happened?
I'm cold and distant to her.
See, your wife, she acts it out. You block it out.
I'm an avoider.
You're an avoider?
I'm an avoider,
yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah, I'm real clear about that.
Yeah.
Probably hard to talk about problems standing up in the middle of the scrap yard. Come on. See my boudoir in the scrap yard?
Beautiful.
How come you didn't tell your wife that you were married before?
It got to a point where, again, avoiding a situation. It was, you know, I didn't tell a bunch of my friends when I moved here that just never did. Just something I put behind me again.
I hear you saying you put it behind you, but I don't hear it as putting it behind you. I hear it as you are convinced that who you are and what you do doesn't matter. Does that resonate in your body?
A little bit.
A little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah. What do you know to be the greatest, most powerful animal in the kingdom? What do you know?
Tiger.
Okay, tiger. But then when you go to the circus, you see a tiger crouched in the corner, following the commands of a man with a chair and a whip. What is it, Nick?
Learn behavior.
Learn behavior, and when he forgets who he is. When the tiger forgets who he is, he's gonna be intimidated by a chair. Come on now. You've been intimidated by a chair, boo. Do you want the responsibility of getting out of the corner?
Yes.
And standing in your majesty and strutting your stuff? Because the tiger, he struts. Tiger don't cower, he don't back down. You got some stuff to strut? Were you strutting your stuff when you had that affair?
Yeah. Somewhere I can be who I was, you know, be who I thought I was. Express myself the way I want to express myself and not get hassled for it. And it meant absolutely nothing, you know?
What did she offer you that your wife doesn't?
She listened to what I said.
She listened. And her listening made you feel what?
Made me feel important.
What else?
Made me feel like I was a man.
Someplace along the way, you've lost that. In the corner. In the corner, cowering. And so when your wife says, you will give me a baby at any cost, what do you say to yourself? What do you say?
I say, it's not the time.
Yeah, it's not the time. Because why?
Because we're not good.
Yeah, we're not good. And we're not good, why?
Because I'm not good.
And I'm not good because why?
Because I've got a lot of unresolved problems.
The one thing I know is that men have an inner life that determines their outer life.
And when a man is not expressing and experiencing connection, intimacy, it says to me that what's broken is in here. It's in here. What's broken here, Nick?
My whole life's about being alone.
Yeah.
No matter who's around me, no matter anything, it's just me and myself, that's it.
So even when you're home with Tiffany, you feel
alone.
And you go in the room, so you are
alone.
Yeah.
There's more stuff in my childhood that I just haven't dealt with, that I, a lot of things that affect me how I am today. Okay. And a lot of things that I need to deal with.
Tell me what that looks like.
When I got sexually assaulted as a kid.
What do you remember about that?
I remember everything about it.
Oh, really? Tell me about it.
I mean, being at a neighbor's house, it wasn't him, it was his friend. His friend told me to come with him to go, and we're gonna go up the street to go get some Cokes, a couple bottles of Coke. And on the way up, you pass a gas station that, on the way to the market, and he took me to the bathroom of that gas station, and yeah, that was it.
What does that mean, that was it?
You raped me.
Okay. Let that settle in your body, yeah. Let it settle in your body. Feel that.
I really don't want to, actually.
Well, you have to, because that, beloved, is what is shutting your heart down.
Nick admits he's never told Tiffany the full story of his abuse.
Are you willing to talk to your wife about how you really feel?
Yeah.
And are you willing to ask of your wife what it is that you need from her to stand in your place of glory and power as the man of the house?
Yeah.
So that means you believe that your marriage is salvageable?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I want you to do some tiger training tonight. So you can't go home. You are going to the hotel. Just give yourself a minute. This beautiful man just shared with you the core and essence of his soul. And where you go to is sadness. Make another choice.
Tiffany and Nick say they're in a sexless marriage.
Some of the things that turn me on to having sex with Tiffany are the way she treats me through the day.
I feel ignored, and I feel really, really lonely.
After our one-on-one yesterday, I gave Nick a little assignment. You are going to the hotel, and I'll let her know that you will not be home tonight.
Hello.
Tiffany.
Yes.
I need you to pull together a few things, maybe a shirt, a pair of jeans, because your husband is not coming home tonight.
Okay.
After spending the night apart for the first time in months, I asked Tiffany and Nick to meet me this morning at a local pool so we can do some trust work.
When there's a breakdown in the relationship, one of the most difficult things to mend is the trust. You see, love is durable. Love can sustain, but trust is very fragile. So we have to go to a place of real vulnerability and softness to rebuild trust. Morning!
Morning.
What's the matter? What kind of face is that?
Me and water aren't friends.
You're not friends?
No.
With water?
No.
Why?
A bad experience as a kid. I don't even want to get into it.
Well, what does being a kid have to do with today?
Oh, nothing. I'm not a swimmer.
How? You don't have to swim. Okay. How was it being home without him last night?
You know, I have not missed him this much in years. Years.
Yeah.
It's a really strange feeling, but a good feeling.
Yeah, well, you don't have to miss him anymore. There him is at.
Hi.
So this morning, I want us to rebuild trust, because that's what needs to be fixed. Your mouth can say anything, but really what's going on in your body is what's going to determine and tell you where you really are. Come, my darling.
television.
Yeah. So, you know, Tiffany?
This was not what I saw.
Yeah. But you know, Tiffany, you say that you don't get along well in the water.
No.
So this is an opportunity for you to live on your hunka-hunka burning love. Mm-hmm. I want you to hold on to your husband.
Okay.
I want you all to get into the water. Remember I said that when trust is broken, intimacy is the first thing to go. So one of the things that I want us to do is I really want you all to get in touch with your capacity to trust one another, yeah? So what would happen, Tiffany, if you allow Nick to just float you through the water?
I'm okay with that.
Okay, so just lay down in his arms and just totally surrender. Totally, no, just totally surrender. Totally surrender. That's not surrendering. Just close your eyes and let your head go and let him hold you, yeah. He's got you, so just relax. Yeah. You're gonna repeat this and complete it for me. The thing I've been afraid to say to you is.
I've been afraid to say to you is that I really want you to be the man of the house.
Tell him what you mean.
You haven't been the man of the house because you haven't made me feel loved and feel that you want me like you're supposed to.
Okay, now that makes your experience about him. I want you to tell him about you. I haven't felt like you're the man in the house because what?
Because you let me run all over you.
Ah, take a breath. So you're aware that you've been running over him?
Yes.
Yeah, tell him how you do it.
I demean you, I ignore you, and I push you away.
And tell him why you do that.
Because I don't trust you.
And you don't trust him because why?
Because he lied and he hurt me.
I want you to put your arms around his neck and get ready to stand up. Yeah, there you go. How was that?
That was good.
Now, it's Tiffany's turn to support Nick. Okay, now you gotta relax your head, Nick. You can still do it, it's all right. Make it easy, take a breath. Make it easy. It's not hard to hold on to the man you love, yeah. Just let him know you're there. The thing.
I've been afraid.
To say to you. Is.
Is that it's hard for me to tell you how I feel inside because I think you're always gonna put your feelings first. Excellent. And your experiences first.
Excellent. And when she puts her feelings and her experiences first, how does that make you feel?
You put your feelings and your experiences first, it makes me feel like my feelings and my experiences are trivial.
The thing. I've been really afraid to say to you. Is
that I feel like we've grown so apart because of me not being able to express how I feel.
Even in your weakness. In your vulnerability, she has not abandoned you.
No.
I want you to feel it. You can. Just need to clear some stuff out. Okay, Nick, I want you to grab her around the neck and get yourself. That is intimacy.
I can feel it.
Yeah.
Make the decision right now. Are you going to cheat on your wife? That is intimacy.
I can feel it.
Yeah.
Nothing to do with sex.
Yeah.
Feels good?
Yeah.
Okay, come on, meet me down here. It was very clear for me to see that Tiffany was finally able to surrender.
Change your clothes, I'll meet you.
And when they came out of that water, I think they were able to just be vulnerable and to know that they can trust again. Now, we've got to translate that back onto dry ground.
All dry?
Yes.
All dried up.
Good. I wanted us to have this time together to talk about what is it that you're not talking about? What is it that you're not talking about, Nick?
I learned that I tend to keep my feelings bottled up. I brought everything from my childhood. Put that onto you. Well, the truth is that, I mean, it's affected me more than I just put it out there. The truth is, I mean, I was flat out raped as a child. Yeah.
How do you feel about what your husband just shared with you?
I'm really sad.
You're really sad. Tell me why sad.
Did somebody hurt him?
That is a learned behavior. Take a breath and make another choice. This beautiful man just shared with you the core and essence of his soul, and where you go to is sadness. Why not say, I feel validated that my husband trusts me?
I do feel very honored that you opened up to me. Yeah. Please forgive me for not listening to you.
Yeah, for being so caught up in my drama.
Being so caught up in my that I couldn't listen to you. Your truth is safe with me.
You do know that.
I do know that. Yeah, I just want you to know that when I told you that, I felt stronger telling you that, and I want you to be strong in that too.
Look at me. Can I show you something? Can I share? One of your secrets with your husband.
Yes.
This is what was covering her heart. Deadness. Hurt, pain.
Sorry you felt that way. I'm sorry I had influence in that, not showing up as a man.
Yeah. And then when you did show up as a man, you did it outside the home. Once you acknowledged to her that having the affair had nothing to do with her, did it?
No, having that affair had everything to do with me and the way I felt.
So now you can make his affair about you personally and stay pissed off with him, or you can remember that this was on your heart. This was on your heart. Do you remember what that looks like?
Oh, yeah.
Give it back to her. Do you remember what that felt like?
Yeah.
And there was a part of you yesterday, we discovered, that didn't want to let this go. Why?
Telling my story made people feel sorry for me, and it made me feel good. I don't want to tell this story anymore.
Together. Together. Together.
I just don't want anything like that ever to come between us again.
Do you trust that you picked the right man?
Absolutely.
Do you trust that you picked the right woman?
Yes, I do.
Yeah. Make the decision right now. Are you going to cheat on your wife?
No, I will never cheat on you.
Okay. Are you going to cheat on him?
Never. I have the most hope I've ever had since the day we got married. I missed you for the first time last night in a really long time.
Did you miss her?
I did.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is your fifth wedding anniversary today. I want you to tell your husband, when you look at him, what you see.
When I look at you, I see an amazing man. Amazing father. And great husband. Thank you for loving me and choosing me to be your wife. Support me in learning to love myself as much as I love you.
I will support you every step of the way, and I know that I just feel good right now. I just feel like we're gonna go somewhere. I really feel it. Happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary.
From here, they're gonna be the best from today. I love you.
I love you.
Tiffany and Nick have come a long way. And before I go, I have a couple of surprises for them.
I wanted to support you and Tiffany in just having a different vision. So let me give you a little present. Oh, visual.
We gave Tiffany a little makeover.
You look great.
So really fancy.
You look good.
A fresh look to match her renewed confidence.
You smell good, too.
Thanks.
When I first arrived, Tiffany and Nick's bed was on the floor. Much like their relationship, it needed a little lift. So I asked my producers to get them a bed frame, new pillows, and linens.
Oh, wow!
I just wanted to kind of give you all a little elevation.
Oh, wow! Oh, this is so nice!
A little elevation and a little motivation. I just want you to know how honored I am that you have let me into the sacred places of your life. I invite you to make up your new bed together. Now, what you do after that is up to you.
Thank you.
All right, so now I'm gonna leave y'all to make up the bed.
Okay.
Y'all go ahead and make up the bed together.
Okay.
Thank you.
Have some fun in there. Y'all do remember what to do, right?
Yes, ma'am.
I think so.
All right, now I'm gonna close the door behind myself, so you don't have to worry about me.
Okay.
Y'all just go on and make up the bed.
Bye-bye.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Iyanla.
Yes?
Can I get a picture before you go?
Are you kidding me? You
Is
in
that
the
wrong?
Bedroom with a man asking me for a picture? You need healing, woman.